Hey guys, so I wanted to go ahead and film this video before too much crap started piling up and making me anxious and wanting to throw it all out. So I have been slowly collecting my empties for you to go ahead and show you what products I actually genuinely use and which products I use and I didn't like. So I guess these are gonna be kind of like mini reviews. I know people on YouTube are starting to do these kind of videos and I actually really enjoyed watching them myself. So I thought that I would show what I use so that you guys can get an idea of maybe things to pick up as well and what to avoid, obviously. So the first thing that I love, I absolutely love this hairspray, like this is my holy grail hairspray, is the Elnett Satin hairspray. It's L'Oreal. This one is Stronghold and this one's Extra Stronghold. So this one is like a baby version and this one is obviously the big version. Duh, Carlene. So they're kind of expensive, so that's why I haven't repurchased this, but I love this hairspray. It's brushable. It's literally it's the finest hairspray used by the finest stylist. Like, honestly, I love it. My friend Mia actually turned me on to this hairspray quite a few years ago, and I've been using it ever since, and I will repurchase it for forever. So if you have not tried Elnett, you need to try it. It'll freaking change your life, in the hair world at least. The next product I hauled in the month of January because my dermatologist recommended it, and I am so happy he did. So it's the Panoxyl 10% Benzoyl Peroxide Acne Foaming Wash, and basically it's a therapeutic acne wash, or therapeutic acne control wash, and it's really creamy, and I just use it day and night. It might be kind of drying for someone, so I started off just using it once per day and used a regular cleanser in the afternoons. Not the afternoons, who washes their face in the afternoon? In the evenings, and I'm so happy for this. So it basically kills all the bacteria on your face. It's not fancy. It comes in like the plainest box you'll ever see. I think it was $11 to $12 at Walgreens, and like, it's just amazing. So I'm really happy that I picked this up. I know they have this one's the maximum strength one, but they have a 4% one too if you just have like milder breakouts. But honestly, you guys, you don't need like fancy schmancy cleansers that like cost tons of money. I used to think that like, oh, okay, well, if it's really expensive, it's gonna do the job, right? Or if it's like really cool and has like bursting beads and like grapefruit scent or whatever, like then I would enjoy washing my face more. No, none of that's true. I am so happy that I found this, and this is something that I actually already repurchased. So love the Panoxyl. The next thing is also a hairspray. So if I don't feel like shelling out $16.99 for the Elnett, then I will reach for the Tresemme. And when I say that I like repurchase these hairsprays, it took me a good year to get through both of these, like in combination, you know what I mean? So this one definitely has a little bit more hold. So if it's more of a hairstyle like an updo, I always reach for the Tresemme. If it's more of a movable hairspray, I'll reach for the Elnett. But I love the Tresemme hairspray. It's really inexpensive and you can find it at drugstores, and I will forever repurchase this as well. The next one is also a hair product. Clearly I go through so much crap when it comes to hair, but it's a Got to Be Smooth Operator Smoothing Luster Lotion. And at first I really didn't think I liked this, but then I really started to like it. It took me about 3 months to get through this, of wearing this every day, and the thing that got me is the scent. I love the smell of this. I don't know why, but I just love the smell of it, and it leaves my hair so silky soft, like when it's supposedly it has cashmere in it, and when my hair just, not my hair, but my extensions just kind of felt kind of gross and nasty, I would just use this, and like seriously, after one use, it works wonders. So I love this. I've already repurchased this as well. The next thing is my Lanakine anti-chafing gel. So if you haven't heard of like using Monistat chafing gel, then for your primer, then I don't even know, you've been living under a rock or something, because I heard about this trick years ago here on YouTube, and I couldn't find the Monistat chafing gel, but I found the Lanakine, and I have forever liked this as a primer. So it wicks away all the moisture, so it does everything that a primer is supposed to do, and it just makes my foundation blend on really easily. I haven't repurchased this in about a good 6 months or so. I haven't used this since the summertime, but I used it the other day. There's like a little teeny bit left in there, and I squeezed out the rest of it, and I fell back in love with it again, and I remembered why I like it. So definitely recommend this. If you guys haven't used this, you should, and if you have used it and if you like it, let me know. Last thing that is in my empties box is the NYX Shine Killer Professional Potion to eliminate the look of oil and shine. So Emily, or My Secret Girl Ambition, recommended this to me like months ago, and I finally bought it over the summer, and I'm so happy I did. So I am so impressed. I'm not impressed at all with the other NYX primers. I actually returned a few of them because I just hated them. It broke my face out, but this one is the bomb. Okay, so this one, I like, especially right here, if I want to use lanolin, especially when I had breakouts, I would use the lanolin down here, and I'd still use this in my T-zone. Why am I doing that? Like, I'd use it in my T-zone. But this stuff is amazing. It doesn't, or it keeps your face mattified. Okay, like, I am just so impressed with this. You can find this at Ulta for like 12 bucks, and I'm obsessed with it. I already have a, another one, and usually I like to switch up my primers and just try new ones, but no, I have found my two favorites right there. So yeah, those are all my empties that I have currently. I don't have anything that I don't like quite yet, at least. Like, I need to work on that. Genuinely, I did return that NYX foundation because it was just complete crap. If it's something that I don't like, then I will return it, okay? I am one of those people. I'm not embarrassed to return it. Like, if it's a product and it didn't, if I bought it with my hard-earned money and it didn't do what it said it was going to do, or if I wasn't impressed with it, then the company needs to know that. And the only way that the company is gonna know is if you return it. The retailer will then send it back to the company, the manufacturer, to get credit back. You know, like, the customer didn't like your crap product that you sold, and so then it tells them to not, you know, to fix the formula or to change it up, or, you know, to remarket it or whatever. So that is why I don't usually keep products around that I don't like. But I will tell you guys that the things that I returned were those Wet n Wild nasty ass lip colors. If you haven't seen that review, I will link it right here, but it was nasty. Okay, I still can't believe that I put that crap on my lips. But so I returned those. And then I also returned the NYX foundation, which I will link right here. I did a review on that as well. I just was not impressed by that foundation at all, and it was just complete crap. So I returned that as well. So those are, I guess, what you can consider empties, or products that I have been using or used up or used and hated. I was about to cuss right there, but I stopped myself. So these are the products that, yeah, I wanted to share with you guys, and I hope you enjoy this video. I'm gonna try and keep things, even if I don't like them, just to show you, or at least try not to return them. But I'm genuinely think that everyone should return things that they don't like, because otherwise, how the hell is the company gonna know that it's a crap product that they're selling, right? So let me know in the comments below if you guys have tried any of these products, or if you guys like these kind of videos, and I'll start collecting my trash like a weirdo and creating these videos for you every time I use up a good amount of stuff. So I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.